Dear students, another important topic of teaching of English language for DLED first year, that is concept, importance and need of oral expression. In this session, we will discuss in detail what is oral expression, its importance, different ways to improve oral expression and its need. First of all, let us see what is oral expression. Oral expression is the ability to express ourselves meaningfully using proper syntactic and phonological language structure. To be successful in society, one needs to master the skill of oral expression. In schools, students use oral expression to process and deliver instructions and to interact with their peer. It is maintained that a student who is good at oral language is supposed to be good in reading and writing. So, it is very important skill. Now, let us see different ways to improve oral expression. We shall take all the points given below one by one. The first one is encourage conversation. To improve oral competence, a teacher should promote conversation. Every social interaction gives an opportunity to practice language. Some students need a little guidance to engage in conversation, so a teacher should spark interaction whenever he can. The second way to improve oral expression is model syntactic structure. Sometimes your students may not complete oral syntax. A teacher should encourage them to do so. When they say broken or fragmented sentences, teacher should complete the syntax back to them. This will certainly boost their confidence. The third point is reproduction exercises. Reproduction exercises is the best way to promote a student to speak correctly. In this method, a teacher produces some sounds and asks the students to reproduce the same. The students listen to them and reproduce those sounds one by one. This practice is carried on in chorus, in groups, and then individually. And every time the teacher increases the number of words to be produced. The next point is questions answers. In this practice, the teacher asks questions from his students one by one, and the students answer the questions. Questions and answers may be between teachers and students, and it may be between two students. The fifth point is maintain eye contact. During instructions, a teacher should maintain eye contact with his students. Maintaining eye contact will help them gauge their audience attention and will allow them to adjust their language and volume. Point 6 is remind students to speak loudly and articulate clearly. A teacher should remind his students to speak loudly. Ask students to feel the muscles used for speech while they are talking and monitor their volume and articulation. Remind them that clear and loud enough speech is essential for holding the attention of the audience. The next point is role play. There may be the role play between two or three or many students. There they may be asked to play role of somebody. The dialogue may be between a doctor and a patient, an inspector and a clerk, or a policeman or a shopkeeper, etc. The next point is by performing actions. The teacher performs actions and asks his students to observe his actions and speak whatever they are doing. Our next point is by showing a picture or chart and a film. The teacher shows a picture or a chart in the class and he asks his students to speak on those pictures, charts one by one. Thus, they get a lot of practice in listening and speaking. Sometimes students are shown a short film in the school and then they are asked to speak a few lines about it. This way and this way they get an opportunity for listening and speaking of a target language. The last way to improve oral expression is through oral composition. Oral composition develops the skill of speaking. The teacher takes up a topic. He asks the students to speak on it. The teacher may provide some guidance whenever needed. This exercise gives a lot of listening and speaking practice. Now, let us discuss the importance of oral expression. The first point is oral expression improves comprehension ability. The students pay attention to what is said in the class. This way, oral expression enhances their ability to listen comprehensively. The next point is student draw pleasure from speaking. They can be seen making a loud noise in the class. They create tumult in the class when the teacher is not in the class. Sometimes they keep on talking endlessly irrespective of teacher's presence in the class. This way, their speaking skill is developed. This also helps in acquiring fluency. More they speak, more they become fluent in speech. Consequently, they become good speakers. Our next point is, it helps the students in becoming good orators. You might have seen the young children are more fluent than others. The spokesperson of political parties who take part in TV discussions or debate are the best example of this. Our next point is, students seek pleasure in reciting nursery rhymes loudly. You may have seen young children reciting nursery rhymes loudly. In the last period, when a primary teacher asks them to recite nursery rhymes, poems, poems or tables, they sing to the fullest of their voice. It gives a lot of practice in oral expression, and they learn correct sentence pattern as well. Next point is, it removes hesitation and boosts confidence of speaker. Oral expression removes hesitation or shyness of a speaker naturally, provided he or she is given a lot of practice in speaking. It also boosts his confidence. Let us see the next point. It makes students to take active participation in teaching learning process. Some students are more curious and talkative than others. They nod their heads continuously while teacher is teaching in the class, and very quickly answer the question asked by the teacher. Thus, they take active part in teaching and learning process. And as all of you know, that a good speaker possesses good personality. Now, let us discuss the need for developing oral expression. Let us take the first point. The quality of communication enables students to assimilate from learning process by empowering them to ask questions and discuss doubts. That means the students who possess good quality of communication learn quickly, because they take the benefit of this quality to resolve their doubts. This way, learning comes to them more naturally. Second point, speaking occupies more space than other skills of learning a language. So, it is the easiest way of expressing yourself. The next point, persons having proficiency in communication can achieve great things in their fields. A number of religious and political leaders are the best examples. You know, illiterate persons communicate only through speaking, and oral expression is useful in social interaction and day-to-day life. So, dear students, this is all for today. Thank you for watching.